No, how did you end it here? What's the last line?
They want me much more.
I think it's pretty much more.
You gotta visualize, okay? You gotta visualize the part in the movie, okay? When you guys transition, you're transitioning into her warming up. So, how do you want, do you want that last sentence to be this and then we hit into the movie, or what do you want? Or do you want it to be, my name is Michaela, type deal? Okay, remember, be quiet.
I used to be a normal girl. School was going fine, cross country was going great. I didn't want anything to change, but that's not how fate wanted to be. Fate wanted me to be something different. It wanted me to change the way people looked at the world. Fate wanted me to be much, much more. Fate wanted me to be something different. It wanted me to change the way people looked at the world. Fate wanted me to be much, much more.
Like, it was really intense when I had to do the voiceovers, because I kept stuttering and like getting it wrong, and I don't know why I'm not doing it right now. Well, it was really hard and intense, but overall, I felt really good about making it. It was awesome.
Okay, you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Let's try that again. Okay. All right, guys, make sure you guys are quiet during this. Okay, the first clip is probably about 6 seconds long, and then I can edit to make sure that it works with that. Okay, but just relax, be yourself, and I might count.
Hi, well that's me, Casey. I'm a normal kid, I guess, except for my mom got sent to the mental hospital.
Good.
Hi, well that's me, Casey. I'm a normal kid, I guess, even though my mom got sent to the mental hospital.
The Frankenstein movie is a lot of fun. I'd have to say that making the monkey was the most difficult part, because when we opened it up, there was just a huge mess of little pieces of styrofoam on the inside.
I hope you guys understand what this guy means to me and what...
Can I touch him first?
We're going to do it with him.
Hold on. I got to give him a hug. I'm going to miss him.
Let's take a picture.
No.
Wait, how was he going to take away?
Oh, stand up. Yeah, get this.
And with that, guys, your project has begun. Oh, goodness.
Oh,
it's not good.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. Man, it doesn't show signs. And I've brought me some corn for popping. The lights are turned way down low. Let it snow, let it snow. When we finally kiss goodnight, I'll hate going out in the storm. But if you really hold me tight, all the way home I'll be warm. And the fire is slowly dying, and my dear, we're still goodbye. But as long as you love me so, let it snow, let it snow.
Ew, that's a mess. Is that, there's hot dogs.
Applaud yourselves, because we got it all cleaned up and we have a monkey. Thank you, Mr. Psycho Monkey, for joining us from Hunkenstein. How did you feel about the overall process of making the movie? I see. Did you have to train a lot to get yourself in any physical condition to attack people and make it believable? Could the real stunt double monkey please reveal himself? Could you describe wearing this monkey suit, nice and loud?
Painful, even as Mr. Russo. Fell on a hill and hit his head on a tree.
And how was it walking around in that thing?
Painful also. Couldn't wear shoes in this.
Alright, thank you.
Okay, to make our movie look like really good, you had to put in a lot of effort. Like for our lab scene when you saw Mr. Russo turning Jordan into a Frankenstein, we actually had to move it 4 times. It was first in Mr. Gambazzini's room, then we had to move it to the stage, then we moved it to the trailers, and then we actually had to move it to the woods just to make it look right. You had to put a lot of effort in thinking into how you think your movie would turn out.
Seb.
Some attitude from you today, Missy.
Hi, Mom.
I wish I would have got that on film.
Shut up.
I wouldn't want to mess with you when you're mad. All right, here we are with Vanessa, who actually came up with the original idea of creating a Frankenstein world, and she's actually credited with saving this class from failing when she blew up on everyone in the trailer on the 21st scene. Vanessa, why don't you talk about that?
Well, people was goofing around and messing around and playing with stuff, and we were goofing around so much that some parts were messed up and we had to do it like over and over again. So I blew up and said I was gonna quit, but I shouldn't have said that. Quitting's not really an option.
Michael jumped on Mr. Russo,
which was my favorite part because, like, that was so unexpected.
Casey, like, dumped all the ice on Mr. Russo, Michael, and he was supposed to only throw like a few kids.
Really?
Bree, where are you going? Bree? Bree, you there? Hello? Bree! Bree! Bree!
Of our feelings, and then we're going to transform them into a
beautiful book.
All right, here we have Ali and the infamous
Family Next Door book that was used in the introduction and one of the major parts that came full circle, obviously, in your story. Ali, how did you make the book?
I basically took a sketchbook and paper mache'd the cover and used coffee to paint the pages to make them look older.
How long did it take you to make those drawings inside?
I'd say each picture would take about 15 minutes to a half an hour. It depended on how big it was and how much time it took for me to plan it out.
And how do you feel about the overall final product of it?
It turned out presentable.
I'd probably say Mr. Russo is really proud of us.
And figuring out a story plot, we all need to be quiet. If you have something to say, raise your hand and say it, okay?
Well said. Your block is finished. My question is, are you ready to see your movie?
Yeah!
Who is ready to see the movie?
Me!
Who wants to see the movie?
I do.
See the movie.
I do.
See their movie. The end. How does it feel that we just filmed at a castle?
It's really cool.
And, ladies and gentlemen, we are finished.
We gotta clean up everything.
Dead keep coming back to walk on a new day, haunting from the bottom to the top of the food chain. Frankenstein roamed the earth to kill the innocent. You would
have
been
nice job.
But claiming that you're safe and your home is a fallacy. He'll hunt you down in the middle of the daylight and eat your brains just to see what it tastes like. He was brought to life in a lab is what the legend says.
Andrew, get out of the woods.
Hoping to survive through the horrible cold, but all that we can do is watch the story unfold.